Hello everyone, I'm Emily Powers and today I'm going to paint a giraffe with acrylic paint and I'm going to show you step by step so that you can paint with me if you want. I have the supplies I'm using in the description and there are also some links to some of the supplies and a percentage of your purchase helps support my channel. And real quick before I start, I wanted to show the schedule that we have coming up. So this is our old schedule for February, and then this is March. It kind of printed funny again, but you can kind of get the idea. So we're gonna have some fun ones coming up. So I'm going to take a half inch Filbert. This is a number 6 Filbert. It's Princeton Summit. It's a half inch, and I'm going to dip my brush in my water, and then I'm just going to do the first layer of the background. So I'm going to get some ultramarine blue and white. So there's kind of like some light blue in the back. And I'll get a little bit of burnt sienna so it's not as bright. And I'll just put that all back here on the top. And if you enjoy the video, please give it a like and subscribe. I post a new video every Friday. And I do tutorials so that you can paint with me, and I've been also putting out time lapses of the paintings that I do step by step too. So I'm going like on the top third at the moment. And I can actually take my spray bottle, I didn't do this, and spray my canvas and my paint so that it'll go on my canvas better and keep my paint wet longer. Alright, and then once I get about here, now I'm going to get some my white and some burnt umber and get some of the blue. And I'll put that right under it. It's like spraying it everywhere, I didn't even realize it. Alright, I'm going to do about as much of that as I did with the blue. And then I'm going to get burnt umber. And a little white. And a little blue. A darker brown. And I'll just put that a little bit more white, not that much darker. And I'm also getting water to kind of help it go a little farther. And what I had up here is kind of dry already. Alright, so that's the first layer that I'm going to do. And I'm going to rinse my brush out. And let that dry so I can do the next layer. Alright, so I think it's good now that I can do the next layer, and I didn't realize how many white spots there are. It's a lot of white spots. So for the next part, I'm going to take my colors and I'm going to use a half inch mop brush too. So I'm going to put it on with this brush and then I'm going to blend it with this one. So you could use a deerfoot like this that I use a lot and do it really similar, but I decided I wanted to do the mop brush this time. I don't do it a whole lot. So I'm going to use blue and I want to get like a darker and a lighter, so there's get some darker here. And then get more white over here. Alright, so I'm going to kind of go around areas where I want it to have the darker color. And then I'm going to put that darker in. Okay, and I'm taking my mop brush and I'm just gonna kind of go in and kind of go in circular a circular motion a little. Just kind of blending it. Put a little bit more light color there. Okay, and then I'm going to keep going. Bit over here. Okay, so this color is a little bit more, had a little bit more of the burnt sienna in it, so I'm blending it in a little bit more blue, so it'll be more the way we had it before. In the dark bit more water. Now it's like drawing. Okay. So I guess it's pretty good. It doesn't have to be perfect. and do Alright, and now I'm going to need to have this blue wet when I blend the brown in. So I'm putting some wet paint right there. Alright. And I need to mix up that this color again. So I'm just going to brush on a lot of that first, and then I'll get just a little bit of a darker and kind of put a little bit of dark and blend it. You don't have to do a lot. Putting blue back here. Okay. All right, now get the dark. I should probably do this part with this brush. This bottom part wet here, and then get a little bit of a darker with the burnt umber and ultramarine blue, a little darker than before. And if it's not going very far, remember to get water again. I'm going to get some ultramarine blue and burnt umber and make a pretty dark mixture and put some dark patches in here and blend them out with the mop. Alright, and now I'm going to get some sap green. I'm going to put some green back here. I feel like the paint is drying on this. Kind of got some water and kind of wiped it on my rag. I don't want the paint to dry. It was kind of getting all hard and like not wanting to do what I wanted because the paint was drying on it. Alright, now you're gonna get more of the lighter around. Okay. So I just want it to kind of look like there's some pockets of grass. Okay, and then we'll get some green. And it's turning darker, it's sap green. But you could probably take, it doesn't have to be this exact green, it's just kind of, it's not a super bright green. So like, you could probably take phthalo green and burnt umber, something like that, and darken it. Kind of cover up a lot more of that brown. So I was just kind of all just these different colors kind of here and there. So I'm getting the green again and putting it back here. I'm going to try to mix a little bit of this color that was the middle. Try to kind of blend out the edge. Alright, so I think it's pretty much done. Alright, so I'm going to rinse my brushes out. I think that's gonna be background. So the next thing I want to do is, while this dries, I'm going to get my paper and draw it out. So I want the head's going to be kind of in the middle. So if I do a dot in the middle, this is this the paper is the same size as the canvas. So that's kind of going to be like the middle of the face there. And I'm just going to say over here. See, there's two eyes. So I'm gonna, it's gonna be some eyelashes, so I'm gonna do two lines like that, and then the eyeball's gonna come in and like that. I can kind of have like an eyebrow, and then there's kind of like a hump, and it goes up that way, and then this other eye, I'm gonna do it pretty similar. See, this one's, the bottom is going to be a little higher than the other one. And it's going to look a little funny before we paint it, but hopefully after it will look better. Okay, so I do down and back up. Here's the eyelash, and then he's got this other section here. And then I'm gonna go in it's kind of going up to his horns. So let's see if the eyes are in the middle. This is the middle. And this is the fourth. So the horns are going to be a little higher than that, like up here. So go up and then it kind of comes back out and then in again. I'm kind of trying to figure it out as I go, so if I'm not really explaining it, it's because I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing too. All right, so I'm gonna do, I go in, and then I have another area that comes up, and then kind of goes in slightly. It's kind of getting just really thick, a lot of pencil. So, out, out, and then out, and you go back in, and then you're going to do a section that comes down. And then it's going to come back up for the other one. And you could draw this on, like, straight on the canvas with a watercolor pencil or chalk. but you'll see what I'm doing after I'm done drawing this. Let's get some like hair coming. I'm gonna do the details later, but then he's gonna look funny until he gets ears, I think, is gonna be kind of what is making him look funny now. Okay, and then do that. Do the side of his face. Oops. Always do that. And I try to get myself more eraser. I always spit all of the pencil lead out. Okay. And the mouth is going to, eyes are in the middle. I'm going to stop the mouth at the fourth, so like right here. So I'm going to go up. And then curve it. In, and from where the eyes are, I'm going to stop the nose a little lower than half. So from the eyes to the where the mouth stops, I'm going to do it lower than this point, the half area. Okay. Okay, so now let's put him some ears so he doesn't look so funny. So right here, this part of the eye, I'm going to come up and right about there, so like across from the horns, I'm going to do down, do a slightly go down, and then about here, I'm gonna come in. And yours doesn't have to be just like mine, or just like the photo. See where the ears are supposed to come out. So I say if you mark it in half and then half again this way, then it would be kind of in the middle that they would come. Right, and then I'm going to go down slightly, and then Okay. So he looks a lot better with ears, that's for sure. It's a little funny without them. I'm gonna do, it's kind of like a, something under his eye, right there. Alright, so his neck, I'm going to start it kind of like where this eyelash is, and I'm going to stop in the corner of the page. So I'm just going to go down there, and then I'm going to start the other side right about here, so the edge of the face comes here, and then the nose, and then right about there, I'm going to stop, so the middle, and then the quarter, I'm going to come a little past the quarter with the neck, so it's a little bigger towards the bottom than where the head is, and he's got to have hair down here, and okay, so I'm going to mark out a few spots, so I'm going to do one kind of like right in here, and the spots don't have to be perfect either. He has to have spots for him to look like a giraffe, but they don't have to be just like I do. And once we paint it, it's probably like the spots and what we draw is going to look a little different once we actually paint it. But and down here, it's going to kind of get covered with some like bushes. But we're still going to see some spots. Okay, so and then in the inside of the ear, I'm going to have like a dark area. Right in here. I'm gonna have like a highlight, some highlights in his eyes. So, and then the nose. I'm just going to kind of put two lines. I'll do more detail once I paint it. So now I'm going to take my tracing paper and I'm going to trace over this so we can see through with this tracing paper, and I'm going to trace my drawing onto the tracing paper. And I probably won't show the whole time that I'm tracing this because you just saw me draw it, so you don't need to see me trace it. So I'm just gonna pause the video until I'm done with this part. All right, so now I've got it traced on here. So I've got my design on here. So now I'm going to pull my canvas. Now this is dry, and I want to line it up with my canvas. And then once I get it where I want, then I pull it back and I put some transfer paper under it. So this is yellow transfer paper, but any color will work if you can see it, as long as it'll show up. So now you can use, I guess, whatever you like to trace it on, but I have been just sticking the pencil lead back in my pencil and being careful not to rip the paper, just kind of go along the edge. Try not to move paper so that it won't end up making the drawing. You don't want like half of the drawing in one spot and the other half in the other spot. So try not to move it once you start. I'm just going on my lines that I want to transfer and just going over them. Do the neck. Do another line where I want the hair. And then the spots. They don't have to transfer perfectly. And if you already drew onto your canvas with a watercolor pencil, then you can just skip all of this part of the video. I probably should have said that before, but you probably know that. All right, so there you go. Now any adjustments that we made before when we were actually drawing with a pencil, and then once we got it the way we want, then we transfer it and it's all clean and nice like that. So that's one nice thing about using that paper. All right, so I'm going to take my quarter inch angular shader, it's Princeton Select, and I'm going to fill him in. So I'm going to start filling in the neck with the titanium white and some yellow ochre and some burnt umber. And some ultramarine blue. So it's not pure white because it's in the shadow. It's in the shade. So I don't want it pure white, but I want it pretty light. And I'm going to go in between all of the spots. And put this in. It's not going to be that bad if you go into a spot, because you're going to go back over that section anyway. I mean, you could actually paint the whole thing in with this color and then trace the spots on the neck with the tracing paper after, if you wanted. I haven't really done it that way before, painted some and then went back and traced again, but you could probably do it. I'm gonna get the spots or the texture of the canvas. I want to get the paint in all those holes. I'll go ahead and get some water. I'm gonna do like a line to the face so that I get it pretty straight, and I'll go back and do the darker spots later. Do it on this side too. Okay, and now I'm going to get some burnt umber and some ultramarine blue some yellow ochre. And just get a brown for the spots. So now I can kind of be a little bit more careful and didn't get in here this hole. So sorry if I'm not really saying a whole lot, it's just, it's not really anything else I don't think I need to say. I'm just filling in all these. And it's just the first layer, so we're gonna do a lot more on it. I mean, it's not gonna look finished at this point, so we just wanna put in all these spots right now. Okay, and I'm kind of running out of that dark, so I'm gonna mix more. And the edge right here is gonna have light hitting it, so it's gonna be lighter, so I'm not really worried about getting the dark all the way over on that one. All right, and then on the face, I'm going to So this side of the face is going to be dark and this side is going to be lighter. So try to okay, I'm gonna get the darker color we use for the spots and put some over here. So he looks pretty bad right now. I'm gonna get some ultramarine blue and do the ears. Put the black in later. Oh, I'm gonna have to mix some darker color, so might as well just go ahead and put that in. Get ultramarine blue and umber, and I'm just gonna kind of a little bit of dark. It's not real dark right now because I had white on my brush, but get some putting some of this where it's pretty dark, and I'm going to fill this ear in with the dark. Okay, get some more of the brown and all right, so now I'm going to get the brown and some yellow ochre. Just put that where I want some. Get it lighter than that and get some more white. Put some right there. I want a little bit of like a lighter brown. Okay, now I'm getting the white. It's gonna be more white on this side. distance. All right, so I kind of went outside the line, so I'm gonna get some water on my rag and wipe it off. Kind of wiped off my lines too, but that's okay. All right, and now I'm gonna need some darker color. Okay, so I'm rinsing that color off my brush so that I don't have all that white. And I'm gonna get burnt umber and ultramarine blue and make it dark. And I'm gonna fill the eye in. I'm gonna give a little bit of the eyelash and this side. It's a little hard to do with this brush, so you could get a smaller one. And then I want to get some dark on the nose, but I'm going to get more of the burnt umber and do some brown. I'm going to get some burnt sienna and yellow ochre, the brown. More yellow and some white. So we do lighter on this side again. Got that filled in, and I still have to do above the eye and the hair on his neck. Just put a little bit of a lighter color on the eye, and then I'm gonna get some of this dark with some burnt umber, and I'll just go on the edge first. And I'll flick out right. So that's the first layer. So he actually doesn't look too bad. I mean, you can tell it's a giraffe, and you know, he's got the spots, he's got the lighter on one side and it's a little darker on the other. And I did this ear dark because the way it's tilted, the sun must be hitting the back of the ear instead of the inside. All right. I think I'm going to, I'm noticing that there's some white spots in the background. So I'm just going to try to fill them in. It's not going in, so I'm going to water it down. Okay. All right, so now I'm gonna go back and do the light color in the neck again. And I think I'm going to change the color slightly from what I did last time. Get white and a little bit of yellow, a little bit of burnt umber, a little ultramarine blue. Actually a little too light, I think. I'm gonna make it a little darker. So it's kinda like gray. A little darker than the other color. Make it a little bit more blue. Make it have more blue color. Tuck it a little bit more white. Do it lighter up here. Get some brown and put some right here. Okay, so now I think I got that better. Now I'm just gonna go back and do the spots again. Actually, let me get the burnt umber and a little bit of ultramarine blue, and I'm going to go back again and do the mane, the hair back here. Right. And now I'm going to get the same color for the spots. thinking to get more burnt umber. Okay, and so we're almost done this. All right, so now I want to take a little bit of white and get a little lighter. Some lighter in some of the spots. It's not all one color. It's not all solid. Right, and then get some blue. Bit of a lighter color, but it's kind of a bluish, a bit more. Right, and then go back and get the brown and kind of go over it some. Okay, get some of the burnt sienna, a little bit of the yellow ochre, and to make a lighter color to kind of go on this side. All right, and then we have the sun hitting it on this side, so I'm gonna get not pure white. Get white and a little bit of yellow ochre. And go on the edge and just so I take it and just flick it out. Okay, so I got the lighter on one side now. And I'm gonna get the ultramarine blue and the burnt umber again, and got these wrinkles. Get some white. Okay, I'm gonna put some of darker So it's got some dark right there. So I'm gonna get some yellow ochre, some white, some ultramarine blue, and some burnt umber. Okay, rinse my brush out, and now there's some lighter color on his hair back here. Get some titanium white and yellow ochre and just do some lighter color. I'm just using the tip of the angle brush and kind of pulling some lighter color. Okay, and I'll get the titanium white. Get the dark again and just kind of go make the ends not so thick. Alright, so now I have to get to the face, and I'm going to start by doing this ear, and I'm going to get titanium white and some burnt umber and ultramarine blue. Let's see. Running out of that burnt umber. I'm gonna have to clean my palette soon. It's getting full. I'm gonna make a darker color over here. Alright, and put that over here. And now I'm gonna mix the burnt umber and ultramarine blue without white and put the dark in the ear. It's kind of a dark section right here. Alright, and I'm gonna go on the edge of the ear and do the dark, but then I'm gonna get titanium white and do this with white because the sun's hitting it. And then I'll get some brown and I'll get a little bit of a lighter color than what we put right here. Do it a little lighter in some spots. And then I'll get the dark, really dark, and put a line there. I'm gonna zoom in so you can really see the face good. There you go. And I'm gonna pause the video so that I can clean my palette off and have more room. Okay, so I'm going to do the ultramarine blue and burnt umber to have that dark. I'm gonna do right up here. Okay, now I'm getting burnt umber and some burnt sienna, and it is still, some of that blue is coming off too, so put that, some of the darker areas. Okay, I'll get some white and add some yellow ochre. You know, it's hard to see when you can't actually see what I'm mixing, but at least when I put it down, you can kind of see the color and hopefully be able to mix it. I'm gonna have to decide either you see it up close and be able to see what I'm painting, or you see what I'm mixing. It's kind of one or the other. All right, I'll put some of this color over here. Get some of that burnt umber and ultramarine blue and do down here. So we're getting next layer should look a little better after this layer. We're gonna get white and some my cadmium yellow medium, or not cadmium yellow, yellow ochre, said the wrong thing, and put some of that in I'll get my light burnt sienna, burnt umber mixture and put some kind of here in the middle. And then I'll get that lighter. Gonna blend that, and there's kind of like a dark, some that burnt sienna mixture again, put kind of like a dark section right there, get some of the ultramarine blue darker, put it there. Alright, and I'll get that lighter yellowish color. Go the outside and blend it out. Okay, on this side, I'm gonna get my white and some blue. Kind of like what we did the neck with, like a bluish, a light bluish color. Gently. Okay. Kind of try to blend that in some. All Okay. And now I'll get some burnt umber and burnt sienna. And put some kind of to the eye from the middle of the face. Burnt umber. I'm gonna get some and do some wrinkles above the eye. Okay, I'm gonna get the really dark color now and put it in there. Put some above the eye. Then get the lighter blue in. That over. Okay. Now, some on this side. I'm getting just like a brown or a, like brown and burnt sienna, and putting some in this side, in this section, and blending it in with the blue. Get more white with that lighter color. Dark again. I'm gonna just take some of that darker color and do some wrinkles on him. I don't want him to like stand out a whole lot though, so do some Okay. And I'll do some on the nose. And burnt umber and some burnt sienna. And I kind of want to blend the top into the nose. Don't want it to look separate. I want it to look like it just kind of is one continues down here. Get some yellow ochre and some of the color I just had. Then I'll get some of the darker again. The yellow. Down there. Okay, and then I'll do some more on this other side of the face. It's a little funny on this side at the moment. Alright, I'll get white. Might have just like a little bit of something in it, but it's pretty bright, and that on this side. And just kind of try, once when I try to like blend into another color that's dry, I try to make sure I don't have a whole lot of paint on my brush, and then just kind of gently go over it. It kind of blends it out. Some white above the eye, and I'll get some of the yellow that I was using on the nose and get some white with it. More yellow. the lighter areas up here. Alright, so he's looking a lot better. And now for this ear, I'm going to get some ultramarine blue and burnt umber. And some yellow ochre. And get some white. Okay, and then get my darker color again for the dark inside. It's just gonna kind of blend again since it's all wet. It's not gonna be as dark at the moment. So I'll have to do that part later. But I'll put some dark on the edge. Okay, and then I'll get more white. Alright, I'll get some of the dark and put some on the edge of this one. And rinse it off. Okay. So now I'm gonna do some of the like grass down here. So I'm gonna take some of that dark color and add some white to it. And some water. And there's more of it over this way. I don't want to come super high, but gets a little bit more white so I can see it over here. So just real easy, kind of flicking it out. All right, and then I'm gonna take some yellow ochre and sap green. Just gonna kind of like tap all these green leaves on here. And kind of just tapping and letting the whole thing come off. Sometimes I'll do just the tip and make kind of like dots. Other times I'll do just the whole edge and it'll kind of make leaves. Right, and I'll get the lighter, more green color. Some more branches a little higher there. Okay. So just do a whole lot, get a little bit more yellow and some green, and get a little bit of white. Do some white, or not white, but lighter with the white. Okay. All right. Rinse that out now. Okay, so we're back to the face again, and I'm going to take number one round. It's Princeton Velvet Touch, and I'll start doing some of the smaller details. So we're going to take my dark mixture. And get some white. white, and then I'll go back with the lighter color. Darker, more like burnt sienna mixture. Going over some of these of a darker spot right here. Okay, and there's a spot in the neck back here. I'm gonna change when it comes, this dark part comes down. It kind of grabs some of the lighter part. I didn't want that. Okay. All right, and then on this side of the eye, there's some lighter color and it's kind of dark back there. So I'm gonna get some yellow, my brown, and my blue. Make a lighter color, put back there. Okay, and I'll get some of the darker and put his nose holes in here. Go. And okay, there's some lighter areas I need, so I'm gonna get white and yellow ochre and some brown. And a little bit of burnt sienna. You get a lighter color and do some on the edge of the nose. So I did kind of like a line right there, and then go up. I'll get some of the yellow and burnt sienna and a little bit of brown to blend. Put some of that more of an orangey color in. Okay, and then get that lighter. Do some lighter right here. Okay, I need to get that burnt sienna yellow and some brown. I'm gonna get some of the darker color, put some in there too, some of the lighter too. Just trying to do more details and change colors and okay, I'm gonna get some more white. Okay, put some white over here. And now I'll get more white in this section, and then I'm gonna get a little bit of that lighter color that had some yellow in it. Put some in there. It's not all solid. Okay, and then I'll do some, he's got some wrinkles on the other side above his eye. I'm gonna take the lighter and put those in. Get some burnt umber. This ear never got the dark in it, so I'm gonna get the ultramarine blue and burnt umber. Alright, so now to do a little bit of that lighter color again, do some on the side. Get some cadmium yellow. Keep saying cadmium yellow. Yellow ochre. Use the cadmium yellow so much more lately, I guess. Keep saying that one. Put some yellow in here. Okay, now get a little of the darker, a little bit of white, and go this side of the nose. Try to kind of blend it out some. Okay, he's got some darker wrinkles in here. And then I'll get get some white and I'll do, there's like some white on the edge of the ear. Okay, and might take a little bit of white with that dark color again. Make a little bit lighter, kind of like gray, and then do some hair up here. Okay, so it's pretty good. I do want to do the eyes, do some more to the eyes though. So, mix up that dark. And then get some white and some of that ultramarine blue, and I'll do a little bit of that. Get a little bit of burnt umber for the other side. Some white and burnt umber. And do underneath. Get a little bit more white with the blue on this side. And get the dark and kind of blend it with that. And there's also some dark right above this eye that I didn't do yet. Do some of it, that wrinkle there. Okay, and then it's got some dark underneath the eye. It's got some of that lighter color right under. In there. Okay. Take a little bit of dark and do put some around there, and you get a little bit of white and do some white over there, that side. So do some lighter color on that side of the nose. And it's probably almost done. Get that darker color under this eye. Get the white pretty good. I don't want to do tons more. I can do some more. Do a little bit more like wrinkles in the neck. And I can get some white, some burnt umber, and some yellow. Do some kind of like wrinkled there. Alright, so I think it's pretty good. Alright, so I'm gonna rinse that, get my rag, get some water, and just go take off some of the outline that's still there. I don't really see a whole lot of it, but I might have to wipe it off later because I've kind of gone all over this side, so I don't want to wipe that off, but I think that's pretty good. I think I'm going to leave it like that. So there's our giraffe. He looks really neat, and I'm going to get my pen to sign it. This is a Faber-Castell Pitt Artist Pen. I'm going to sign it over here. Okay, sorry. So I didn't realize I was zoomed in. I knew it, but I guess I forgot. I forgot to zoom out. So there's our giraffe. I hope you enjoyed this. Hope you paint it. This is the schedule for February, and so we already did all those. So you can hit Emily Powers Art right below the video and it will take you there. And then this is what we're doing in March. So it's kind of hard to see exactly what it looks like with the lines from the printer, but that's basically what we're doing. So I hope you enjoyed this and had fun painting it. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like and subscribe. And thanks for watching. Bye.